My name is Kanak Agrawal and today we are going to study about idioms. So, these are some of the idioms I will be telling you which you can use in your daily life. Most of them will be from starting with the letters A, B and C. So, let's go on, let's start. First idiom goes as follows. A blessing in disguise. What does it mean? Something good that we do not recognize at first. Well, the sentence for it can be, quitting a job resulted as a blessing in disguise for him, because then he could pursue his dream job. Second idiom of the day, all the tea in China. What does it mean? It means not at any price. Now, it has got some interesting history behind it. Well, we know that China is major producer of tea even now. So, doing something at the price of the major chunk of tea production is not worth doing it. Got it? Now, what can be the sentence with it? Well, it can be, I wouldn't give up football not for all the price of all the tea in China. Well, now let's go to the next idiom. It is at the drop of hat. We can make that out, right? What would be the meaning of it? It means doing something immediately. What can be the sentence we can make from it? Well, I want to make a cake at the drop of the hat. I am so eager to taste it. Now, let's go to the letter B and make some idioms, learn some idioms from letter B. First idiom, baker's dozen. What does it mean? It does not mean a long sentence. It means a number. It means 30. Why 30? Now again, we are curious to know more about baker's dozen. Because dozen is 12, right? Yeah. So, what is the history behind baker's dozen meaning 30? So, in the earlier time in England, when the bakers used to give bread, loaves of bread, a dozen of loaf, well, they used to give one extra loaf to the people. Why? Because they were afraid that they do not get penalized for weighing less. So, that is why it became baker's dozen. 12 plus 1. Now, what can be the sentence we can make about it? We can make that I carry a baker's dozen of chocolates in my purse every day. Now let's go to the fifth and last idiom of the day. Bite off more than you can chew. What does it mean? It means doing or taking up some job that is too big for you. Now let's create a sentence. What could be the sentence? Well, I bit off more than I could chew when I decided to clean my home. So these were the idioms that I hope you liked and you will go more than once or twice so you could use them in your daily lives. Thank you and have a good day.